Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Zen Dynamics. I'm Dominic White, and this guy is still dead. And today we're entering the city itself as we take one step into the open world, and yeah, apparently it is time for some cleanup duty. By cleanup, I mean spilling a lot of blood, which doesn't sound very clean, but whatever. Okay, I'm going to be playing this bit very cautiously because, well, there are some unpleasant surprises around the corners here. Like round this corner. Ah, Jesus! Ah, I really, really hate Imp Warlords. They have a huge range of powerful attacks, and aha, right, here's the satanic Pokeball I was talking about. Fortunately, that thing has really short range, but it can actually do quite a lot of damage up close. A Mancubus round here. Mess him up. And that was just a tad too close for comfort. Fortunately, the pistol is awesome and does huge damage even against Mancubi. Brilliant. So, having a quick look around, what have we got here? Right, round this corner are probably my two most hated enemies in the level. A pair of, they're called Maelstroms, and they are the evil, sadistic bastard cousins of Lost Souls. You do not want to see them fire, ever, because they have a massive area effect damage spell. I am so lucky that they didn't actually get to kill me, right? Dealing with this revenant here. And right, barrels! They explode a lot quicker here, and tend to kill you a lot more easily if you are careless. Deal with a couple of cacodemons here. Spilling... I use the ult fire on the pistol there, which is really powerful and can clear an entire room if you're careful. There's a baron here, and... Oh yeah, I forgot about something. Here! Right, as you can see, that took off a huge chunk of my health. One thing I find kind of iffy about this mod is a lot of attacks do just ridiculous damage if you're careless. Two or three hits, even from full health, and you're wiped out. Which means I'm fairly cautious and evasive, as you can see. And, yes, I forgot about that guy. Heavy weapons guy up in that tower, picked him off with the pistol, which is a good sniper weapon. Right, my second most hated area of the level is right up these stairs, as you're about to see. Once I clear out this guy, die, die. Ah, right, he's dead. And run, run away, help, ow, burning fire. Right, as you can see, there's an entire room of cacophytes up there, and they can and will chew you into little bloody chunks in about 4 seconds. So I'm slowly scouting the area around. All clear. Hoover up some extra ammo, as I will need every bit I can get. And into the central building. As you can see, this is somewhat more organized and less abstract than normal Doom level design. It's kind of an industrial complex. It's a little more detailed than anything in Doom 2 city levels, which just tended to be large square rooms with... I wouldn't say there was any real sense to them being decorated. They were just random demonic symbols hanging from the walls. And they tended to be large, empty areas. Alright. How much blood did that guy have? Right, I search around here. Okay, there's another Imp Warlord. I'm being very cautious right here. I'm not entirely sure if enemies can shoot through these barriers, but I'm not taking any chances. And, oh, Jesus, fuck. Right. Yeah, lucky there. Pick off these two guys. And now I'm going to show off. Boom. Right. That guy has actually killed me a couple of times in previous takes on this level, so excuse me not letting him fire this time. Just killing him quickly and efficiently and safely, that's good for me. Right. To get forwards, we have to go down and then up. Okay, maybe the level is a bit abstract and surreal. Makes no sense, really, but... Okay, right. Enemies off in the far buildings there, which I shall not even bother trying to kill. There's actually no real reason to at the moment. There's the key I'm after. And some Zenroids, which I'm not going to be using yet. Right, this acts as both a full health recovery, which you can carry around with you, and it also switches you into a Berserker mode, and given how powerful the knife is normally, it does absolutely brutal damage when doubled. Up here. Right, we have got another heavy weapons guy. Deal with him. Grab the key. grab the invisibility. Well, after we clear the path, I do not want any unpleasant surprises there. Now, back down the lift. And where's that switch? Where's that? There. No. Right. There. Good. In we go, and we're about to grab a new weapon, the Stinger Assault Rifle, which has an alt-fire arced grenade mode. Very, very Half-Life. But we're not going to be using that for the moment. We're just going to... Oh yeah, that. I keep forgetting important switches. Right, there's another invisibility power-up up there. I'm saving that for later. There's a reason for it. And, right, you may see a little time skip here. That is because I went and saved game, just in case I died horribly here again. And yes, I have died right here, just past these demons, in fact. As you can see, the primary fire on the pistol is pretty powerful. It's not quite chain gun level, but does the job. I'm gonna slowly pick off these barons. There's, I think, two barons here and a few hell knights. Maybe just one baron. Right, and around the corner. Yep, hell knight. And at least one cacodemon. Deal with him. Notice that they actually bleed appropriate colours. I mean, cacodemons bleed blue, hell knights and barons bleed green, etc. And that splatters on the walls. Nice detail. Right, so into this ominous central building, which we're not actually going up into. We're going up creek without a paddle. As appropriate. And round this corner, right, I am pre-pumping the shotgun because I hate these guys. I mean, each of them fires about 3 or 4 shots in a burst, and each of those shots does 10 damage, roughly. So you can die pretty much instantly if you drop into that room without being prepared. I pick them off. And delicious health, and an extra impact grenade for the rifle. And there's the key up in after on an ominous button, which we... Yeah, can't be evil. Nothing can go wrong, we just grabbed a keycard in a Doom game! That means everything's going to be great, and it's going to let us straight out of the level. Yeah, no. Right, so, we hop up here, the little ledge you can see. Exit. And the music changes, and you'll notice in the top center there, a boss health bar. Yep. Boss in the second level. Now, where is he? Where is he? Oh, Jesus. Yeah. Meet the Arachnophyte, a flying, jetpacking Arachnotron. It has a lot more health than a normal Arachnotron, and it has a high-caliber machine gun. As you... Jesus! Okay, that was dramatic. Right, this is why I left the invisibility power up there, because I think in this mod it actually causes bullet-using enemies to lower their accuracy against you rather than just making you semi-invisible. I'm going to use the Xenoids here. That doesn't look pleasant, but... Okay, now, ow, 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 what am I doing wrong here? Oh yes, I'm using the knife. I am a complete fucking tool. Right, get out the assault rifle, and let's use something decent on this guy. As you can see, it's doing quite a lot of damage against him, chewing away a good chunk of his health bar. He's on low health now. I'm staying behind this pillar for reasons of personal safety, because when this guy dies... Boom. Right. If you are at ground zero of that explosion, you can lose like 90% health. And of course, if you're going to be shot by him, yeah, you're going to die instantly. I'm doing one last run round to pick up any remaining ammo that I need, and into the level exit. Onwards to the next... am I missing something? Yeah, I am. So, yeah, turn round, back into the main building, and... Why, that wall looks suspicious. Boing! Now it's glowing blue. And what does that do, I hear you ask? Or, I imagine hearing you asking. Sonic jump pad! Only I hit the wall, because I'm an idiot. Right, jump again! And we chew through these guys as quickly as we can. There's armor there, and round the corner there is a mega health, which I will really need. Alright, we pick that up, and we are well on to our way to a more interesting location. A secret is revealed indeed. This area only opens up after you kill the boss, so if you try and get to the secret area before the boss, nothing much of interest. Pardon me. and onwards. Things look to be getting a bit more high-tech here. Going up the lift, if you heard a sound there, that was my screensaver kicking in. Terrible, I know. Right, forwards once more onto the breach, and a room full of demons, which we shall mow down with the auto pistol. The alt fire on the pistol, that you may have noticed me using a couple of times, fires a three-round burst, solid, instantaneously. It's like a mini shotgun. It does a lot of damage. It can usually kill imps in one hit, larger enemies in four or five. It's especially good against the imp warlords if you don't have shotgun shells to spare. And now we go into the first of several lifts to our horrible, painful destiny. This one appears to be travelling sideways. How very sci-fi. And is shaking ominously, but that's because it probably just isn't oiled, I think. Round the corner, more horrible bastards! Die, die, all of you, die! Yeah, notice the comfy sofas all around, but it is no time to be sitting down. It is time to be shooting people. That there's a revenant in that room, and I really, really hate them because their rockets can do absurd damage, as I mentioned. I shall crouch and be sneaky. Oh, right, yeah, you notice that took out a huge chunk of my health bar, so I shall gunnish him, in the words of Evil Tim. Now, which way, which way? Right. Aha, the door. Fatal error. What does that mean? Not a bug, it just means someone's been doing something in here, like hiding ammo clips inside the ventilation shaft. That's fine. That looks like an access hatch. Ta-da! We hit the button. Just making sure. Yep. Right, elevator test. That can't be unsafe at all. Jumping on top of a moving elevator in a demon-infested building. Yeah, right. And next time on Let's Play Zen Dynamics, the first secret level. See you there.